Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. What I want to introduce today is through VFX Graph and SDF to create when the particles contact the model surface. We'll generate a map along the surface of the model. It can create an effect similar to when the shield is hit, or the feeling of ripples on an object. Okay, let's start making it now. First, make sure VFX Graph is installed. Then go to Preferences. Check the experimental operators of visual effects. We will use this later. Next, let's create a new VFX Graphy file. Then we choose Simple Loop. This time I use the latest version 6000 of Unity, because it has some functions that will be used this time. Next, we put in a character model. I already have a character model. Let's take a look first, and then put it into the scene. Then we adjust the size and rotation value. We move the particle emitter to the front of the model. Then open the VFX Graph Editor. Let's edit the nodes of this VFX graph. Let's adjust the number of particles. Change bounds mode to manual. Set its center to 0. Then adjust the range size to 100. It is erupting upward now. We adjusted it to erupt on the character. Adjust the direction value. Then adjust the speed as well. Let's take gravity away. Then add a set size. Make it smaller. Remove the linear drag too. Then the next key is here. We add a collision shape and distance field. Adjust the parameters. Just use this to make SDF-related settings. Then we remove the unnecessary nodes underneath. Add an orient along velocity. And set color. Adjust the color. Then add subpixel anti-aliasing. Next, we need to add two external parameters. One is transform. Named base transform. Then add axis align box. Named SDF box. Pull these two to the node editing page. Then we add a transform position. Then add a vector 3. Then connect the base transform node to the transform. Connect the center of the SDF box to the position of the transform. Then add a multiply. Connect the transform's angles to vector 3. Connect the scale to the of multiply. Then connect the size of the SDF box to column B. Next, connect the output of transform to the center of collision. Connect the output of vector 3 to angles. Connect the output of multiply to size. In this way, it can correctly detect the position, rotation, and size of the model. Let's take a look at it as a whole. We then do the behavior after the particles collide with the model. Add a new trigger event on collide. And then connect to create a GPU event. If GPU event does not appear when you create, that means experimental operators is not checked. Remember to check it. Then adjust the number of particles. Then add a set position. Then adjust its source. Adjust to source. Then add a lifetime and size. Then the next focus is output. Here we need to select output particle forward decal. Use this. It can paste the texture onto the surface of the model. Set particle positioning to local. Then we return to the scene. Take a look at this model. Then we make an SDF of this model. Select Visual Effects, Utilities, SDF Bake Tool. Model source uses mesh. Then pull in the mesh of this model. Then select Bake Mesh. We'll create an SDF file. Then save this SDF file. Save to the location we want to specify. I have already saved it here. Okay, let's see next. Pull the generated SDF to distance field. Next, go to the scene and click on the VFX file. Add a new VFX property binder underneath it. Then add a transform. Then pull down and select the previously set base transformer. Then pull the model into target. And because we just scaled the model, so the size of SDF box needs to be enlarged a little. Okay, this way our effect will come out. You can see that when the particles reach the model, a map will be generated along the surface of the model. Then we adjust the lifetime loss to 1. The erupted particles will disappear when they hit the model. Next, we try to change the texture on the model. Replace it with a hollow circle texture. Then add some effects to it. We have added a new set size over life. Composition, select multiply. Adjust the curve. Then add a color to it. Add set color over life. All we need here is color. Let's give it a brighter effect at first. Then we use blue. Turn up the intensity. The color at the back is darker. This is probably the color change. Then size and lifetime can be adjusted again. We can also change it to random. Use two sizes. Then lifetime is also set to two values. This way the variability is richer. The color of the erupted particles has been slightly adjusted. Make it more in line with the bright blue color scheme. The particles can be smaller. Make some final adjustments. The speed of particle eruption can be slower. Let's take a look at the performance in the scene. Let's turn the model and see. It will also follow the shape and surface of the model to generate textures. There will be no problem moving the model. Turn in various directions and test it out. Okay, then we try to change it to different colors and textures. First, adjust the color of the erupted particles. Then put the texture generated on the model. Replace it with this left one. Then change the color to red. Same, The front is brighter. It's darker behind. See the effect. Let's try to change the model next. Let's change to a sphere model. Make it smaller first. Then hide the character model. Then we also create an SDF file from this sphere model. Because I just did it first, let's demonstrate here. There is already an SDF of a sphere here. Let's replace it. Then remember to modify the outside as well. Target needs to be replaced with a sphere model. Then the size of this SDF box needs to be adjusted. Adjust all to 1. That's it. Rotate and take a look. We can also change to different textures. Use star textures instead. If you have other textures, you can use them yourself. Okay, that's the end of today's teaching. Anyone who wants to download the file can join my Patreon membership. You are also welcome to subscribe to my channel. See you next time.